Energy Answers for the Beginning Farmer and Rancher program presents, How Do I Make Pellets on the Farm? At the heart of the pelleting process is a die, a thick piece of metal with holes in it, and one or more rollers. The rollers travel over the surface of the die, providing a pinching action that forces ground biomass down into the die. The tapered holes squeeze the biomass and resist its flow through the die, causing heat and pressure that fuses those particles of biomass into a solid pellet. But what do you practically need in terms of technology and know-how to get started with on-farm pelleting? For the purposes of this video, we're going to assume that you already have biomass feedstock that can be made into pellets. This could be woody material from a forest or plantation, crop residues like corn stover or wheat straw, or even a biomass crop such as switchgrass or miscanthus. This video will quickly cover the equipment you need to turn that feedstock into pellets, including how to prepare for making pellets and how to run a small-scale pelleting process. If you like equipment, that's good, because you're going to need several pieces of equipment to make pellets on the farm. First, you need size reduction equipment, usually a coarse grinder or chipper and a fine hammer mill. Next, you will need a mixer and/or some means of either drying or adding water, depending on whether your feedstock is too dry or too moist. The pellet machine is, of course, the main device needed, although physically it is just a small part of the overall system. After pelleting comes a cooling rack and any handling or packaging equipment that you may need. Your ingenuity will definitely come into play when it comes to assembling the equipment into an overall working system. Once you have the equipment assembled, you can prepare your biomass for pelleting. First, you must grind the biomass to a regular, repeatable size range. This is usually defined by the size of the holes in the grinder's screen. For pelleting, it seems to work best if the biomass is ground down to a size that is no larger than the diameter of the holes in the pellet machine die. For example, if the pellet die holes are 6 millimeters in diameter, the grinder screen size should be no greater than 6 millimeters. Experience has shown that grinding tends to work best when done in two stages. First, a tub grinder or chipper is used to create coarse particles. Then the coarse material is fed into a hammer mill that grinds it down to its final desired size. Next comes moisture adjustment. This is critical for successful pelleting and requires accurately measuring the moisture content of your feedstock and either drying it down or adding water to get it into the optimal range. Most biomass pelletizes successfully when water content is somewhere in the 12 to 18% range. Now it's time to actually run the pellet mill. Every model of pelletizer is a little different, but in general, you should first adjust the tightness of the rollers to ensure the proper squeezing action between the roller and the die, and second, ensure that all safety guards are in place. Then it's time to turn on the machine. You may need to let it run for a few minutes so that the die warms up to its operating temperature, and then you can start adding material to the pelletizer. Depending on what you are pelleting, you may need to add a pre-mix of material that creates the necessary back pressure in the die to ensure quality pellet production. A 50-50 mix of distiller's dried grains and ground switchgrass has worked pretty well for us for that purpose. Smaller machines with their exposed rollers often work best if you keep a thick layer of feedstock that covers the rollers. This helps to trap moisture in the die area so that the feedstock doesn't dry out before it is pressed into the die. It's also handy to have a stick of some sort to agitate the feedstock and break up any bridging that may occur. If all goes well, pellets should start coming out of the chute of your machine. You'll find that they're warm and soft, and they need to be spread out to dry, cool, and harden before they can be packaged or used. Keep in mind that each pelletizer and each feedstock is unique, and some experimentation may be needed to settle on the exact settings and procedure that works for you. You can learn more about the pelleting process from other materials that are in the Energy Answers for Beginning Farmers and Ranchers series, including videos on measuring moisture content and measuring pellet durability.